Party crews have always been a part of the gang culture in Chicago. From the 70s to the 80s, they used to say, we have the girls, the parties, and the dance-offs. Yes, the dance-offs. Let's get into this video. In a city known for its fearsome super gangs, criminal enterprise like the mob, gangs, Chicago has its own culture, from graffiti on the walls to how the South Side and the North Side are separated. In Chicago, it's where you're born that defines who you are, not your race. This is gang life.
Cartel got me working for the big faces. Federale got my car full of brick cases. Hit the pin with a grin, there ain't no faking. Eyes picked to my back for my shoelaces. Got out, should have seen the look on their faces. All jealous because your boy stacking hella paper.
Hey, what's up? My name is JC. I am Wrong and Strong. If you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe, leave a message, thumbs up, thumbs down, don't matter. If you're part of my crew, mi familia, mi pandilla, mi raza, my gang, súbanse a la suburban, let's get this party on the road. Party crew's purpose back in the day was to not gangbang. Sex, drugs, and rock and roll. We don't die, we only get high. That's what they used to say. And a lot of these crews, you know, grew up in gang neighborhoods. So this is why they would form party crews, so that way they wouldn't get into that whole gangbang, you know, scene. But what they failed to realize is that most party crews actually came and were based out of a neighborhood. So that made them rival with other party crews and other gangs and crews. So it ended up being almost the same. And then the worst part would come when other gang members would see these party crew members in other neighborhoods, and they would be like, yo, I seen dude in Kings, 2-6, SD's hood, and then it was all downhill from there. But they've been a big, big part of Chicago history, culture, and gang affiliation. Also, the gangs that ran the neighborhood the party crews were from would keep a close eye on them, because if they became too powerful, then they would make them join or shut them down. And this is how a lot of party crews end up turning into full-blown gangs, or, you know, end up joining different organizations, because sometimes they would break up and join, you know, Land Kings, SDs, and stuff like that. So they would break off and join. I've seen it with my own eyes, you know. And that's the thing, is that one of the original party crews that was really big and had a lot of respect at one time was the K-Town Party People. This is before the 2-6 were a powerhouse in K-Town. By the 90s, the 2-6 has taken over most of K-Town, or all of K-Town, I should say, and told them either quit or join. And that's how it is for most of these party crews. In the 90s, you had the OT boys, the Nike boys, the Adidas boys, LTBs, Nasty Boys, KGBs, Sin City Boys, LA Boys, Funk Boys, and the Guest Boys. I was a guest boy. I was really young and I was into dancing. So I was a guest boy from 57th by Gage Park. Lupe at the time was the chief and leader. But I was in it because I liked to dance. I would dance. I was actually in the dance crew, like class or whatever you want to call it, at Morton East. So after school, we would, you know, practice our moves. And I would have dance-offs. You know, we would meet up at, you know, all these places where this is the time where, you know, Freestyle, Heart Drop, Bad Boy Bill, Little Susie, Diamond Girl, Julian Jumping Perez, you know, it was a time that we're never going to get back again because it was cool to like dance. I mean, think about it. Even the taggers in Chicago would fight. I remember Bus used to be one of the biggest tag crews. You would see their tags all over Chicago on the buses, everywhere. And they were fighting with other crews. So, I mean, I don't know if it's a Chicago thing or like it's just embedded in our culture, but neighborhoods are neighborhoods. And that's the thing that I can't let these youngsters forget where they come from, because like I said in the past, I am not glorifying that whole life. I'm making you remember that there was a different time where it wasn't that bad. It's really bad now. All the shootings, all these groups breaking into other groups. You know, there was a time where everybody did get along. There was a time where everybody did party. And it was more than just colors, gangs, streets. It was a lot different. But nowadays, I mean, you see it. You have the same organization fighting the same one on another street because of this, because of that. And it's all because of money, power, I guess you could say the shine. But at the end of the day, like I was telling one of these young kids that messaged me the other day, you're going to go into prison and you're going to end up kicking it with those people. So at the end of the day, for what? Was it worth it? I don't think so. I look back at all the years that I spent on 59 fighting everybody. Then at the end, my own people tried to get me and I ended up on 26th Street back home. And it was for what? For nothing. For nothing. Because at the end of the day, everybody moved on. Everybody that passed away. Everybody that's doing life is doing life. And look at us. All we have left is memories. So why not make them good memories? My name's JC. I am Ron the Strong. Hey, don't join a party crew and think it's going to be okay, because it's not. You're going to end up fighting. You're going to end up doing something stupid. And at the end of the day, it's still gangbanging. So don't judge nobody. Stay in your lane. Live savage. And remember, you only have one life to live. But if you live it right, one life is all you need. I'll catch you guys on the rebound.